Two more. One. shrug the shoulders. 8. Hold on. 7. There we go. 6. High hinge squats. But they feel good. Release the stress. 2 more. Right arm hammer curl. 4 sets. Up for 2. And down. Now, your knees are soft. Your ribs are the hips. Increasing the height. That belly button is pulled in and outward. 1 more. Shrugs. Ready. Let's go. 8, 7, 6, and 5. 4 more, 4, and 3. That body's already saying that left arm's gonna curl. Hammer. Up 2, down 2. Get bucks.
Goes way back. One more. Left leg back. We're launching down.
shoulders, knees to knees. The sink is two, come still. Right arm in front for two. Left side. Don't reach, just lift naturally. And as you're sitting against the wall, tuck the tail, hollow out those abs. Do it again, do it again. Shoulder weights down, don't let the shoulder. dragon right, dragon left. Again, right side. Thank you. 7.5. Maybe from 7.5 to those 5. We're gonna work that back. Yeah, your backs are strong, right? Right? And I say this every time I introduce the set of my visual. Grab those two weights, put them in your weaker side. It might be your left if you're right-handed, it might be your right if you're left-handed. But it might be your right if you're right-handed. And it might be your left if you're left-handed. So two weights. Alright, right hand on the right side, left hand, one more. Whatever side does not have the weight, because my weak side is not your weak side. Right? So put it in your weak side. Take the opposite hand on the opposite leg. Step right back, bring that elbow down, let the arm hang. Now roll it for two. Pull and down. Again, exhale, inhale. So your chest is parallel to the floor. Good, 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 good. Nice lie back. Good, good. Do it again, do it again. Exhale, exhale. Inhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale. Inhale. Four more, don't rush. One, two, down. Good. Three. Two more, two more. One more. All right, let's switch it. That should not have felt too bad. Because our backs are much stronger than we give them credit for. And I'll tell you why, because I didn't give you my visual yet. All right, opposite hand on the opposite leg. Now put that forearm down. Ready to lift for two. Here we go. Pull. Keep the shoulders bridge to the floor. Exhales up and inhales down. Do it again, do it again. It's not my workout. So, my visual. I know most of us do the primary grocery shopping. And probably, when you get home, there's no one to help you bring the groceries. So, if you're like me, I'm not making 10 trips. Maybe I make 2. So I'm going to overload. One more, one more. Alright, release it. So think about that. If you're right, it's your opposite arm. And of course I lost the mic. That's okay, I have a battery. So think about that. If you're right-handed, you're gonna stack everything in that left side, yes or no? Unless you guys all have help and get home from the grocery store. We're carrying all the groceries. So my left side, even though I'm right-handed, is stronger. All right, step your mat down. Keep your weights with you. Because sometimes your stronger side is not your dominant side. That's what I'm trying to get at. All right, take your mats down to the floor. We're gonna start with your chest. All the way down, knees are bent. Now remember to challenge this. So, maybe if you always use 5s, maybe use 7s. If you always use 7s, maybe put your 2s with your 7s. Maybe put your 5 with your 7s. All the way down, knees are bent. Elbows wide. Make sure you back up comfortable. Knees are bent, elbows on the floor. Now, I need you to imprint your spine. So hollow out the belly, roll to that spine. Retract your shoulder blades back and down. Now, the shoulder blades are not allowed to come off that floor. Elbows to the ceiling. Press up two, down two, ready, set, go. Up and down. Exhale. Inhale. So make sure you want to feel your chest before you feel your shoulders. You can't get your shoulders all the way out of this move, but if you contract your shoulder blades around your spine and back it down into the mat to the floor, you're going to keep your spine out of the chest. Elbows bent to the right angle, that spine is extended into the floor, squeezing behind you. Pressing the heels into the floor as well. Up for two. Down for two. Exhale. Shoulders come off. Up two, down two. Give me four more. Four. One more. All the way up and halfway down. Single. Just the top half. Go with the elbows touch that floor. Four more. Four. Good. Three. Two. All the way up and down. Single. Take eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Now bring them down. Place them on top of the desk. Stack whatever you are holding right on your desk. Hand over hand to hold those weights down. Pull those heels in. Now with that weighted hip, we're going to lift up two, down two. Pelvic lift into a bridge. Up for two. Oh! Exhale. Squeeze that booty. Press those heels down deep to the floor. Again. Right now we're going full range. Heart switch to the top. Exhale. All the way up and halfway down. Single. Eight. Seven. Six. Halfway down. Five. Four more. Four. Three. Two more. We're going to freeze three counts in the air and one count down right here. Three. Two. Three. Tap that floor. Hold, two, three, tap that floor. One, two, three, tap the floor. One, two. Now pulses, three counts. Three, two, one, tap that floor. Three, two, one, tap that floor. Hold tight, don't want to pull off. Again. Single count, full range. Eight, seven, six, one more, four, and three, last two, last one. All right, peel them off. You need to have one set, whether your triceps to the side. What do you want to use for your triceps? So I'm gonna hold my 7.5. Maybe you want fives. Now go over the wrist, over the elbow, over the shoulders, walk your hips, contract the shoulder blades. Now, you're gonna pretend you're gonna answer the phone. We're gonna hang up right back up, down for two. Elbows over your shoulders. Make sure you get them all the way down. Pretend that inside weight towards the thumb and the index finger. Loosen the earpiece. Comes all the way down to the ear. Inhale down, exhales up, four more. Good. Three. Two more. Keep both together, one more. Down three, up one, ready, set, go. Move it, two, three, and back up. Not three steps, three fluid counts down. Woo! I believe we've got four more to go. One, two. Now, don't forget about the back. It is imprinted, that's fine, it's the mat. Shoulder blades contracted back and down. One more. All right, lock them up and hold. Squeeze shoulder blades back and down. Lock here, hold. Isolate. From here, remember that hip up? Up two, down two, no extra weight. Up and down. Shoulder blades contracted back and down. Isolating. Let the upper body hold. Four more. Don't rush anymore. One more. Now up four counts and hold. One, two, three. Now wrap those knuckles around the wrist, around the elbow. Chest fly. Hold it for two. Now hold it. Wrist is rounded. Shoulder blades contract the back and down. Squeeze the hind knee. Push those heels right to the floor. Right back up to the top. One, two. four, bend the leg, flex the foot. Lock it low, contract the shoulder blades. Push that right leg away, push it out, pull it in. Keep those hips lifted. Try to keep the weights in the air. Straight out, straight in. Imagine pushing something away from you. Woo. Now, drop the butt on the in. So it's out, drop. Lift and drop. Push it away. Press up on that left heel. Four more here. Four. Three. Two. And one. Reset, hold. Lock it up. Pull that left leg in. Flex that foot. Lean over the hip. Pause and hold. Stay here. Stay here. Contract your shoulder blades. Reset. Four. Three. Left heel pushes away. Let's go. Push it out. Out. You stay lifted. I know they already know what's going to happen here. Our heart is holding those weights. Two more here. Drop that tiny every in. Here we go. Out. Drop. Push. Drop. Feel that work in that ham. That right cheek. Again. Hold. Four more. Four. Three. Last two. Last one. Good. All right, bring it on down. Bring those weights down. We just need one. Sandwich it. Whew. All right, bring those feet together. Let those knees fall outward. Now, what happens here is your back will arch. You can't let it arch. So once those knees fall open, lock your ribs back into your hips. Contract the shoulder blades. Take that weight over the chest. Now we're going to do a skull crusher. Bend the elbows down for two. So we're only holding one weight. Right at the end of the weight. And we're bringing it down right at the center of that forehead. Contract the shoulders. Back and down. That spine is rigid. Is that tiny? Four more.
Or you can always come down to your elbows.
All I need is a flat back. Flex that right foot. Snap the hips. Slap the back. Right leg up for two. Keep the foot flexed like you're lifting the ceiling tile. Okay, more tight. And stack them steady. Imagine you're looking at the ceiling tile with that flexed foot, nothing but this. Okay, four. And three. Two more. One more. Hold now, let's go. Eight. Seven, squeeze that booty. Six. Five, four more. Four, good. And three, flex that foot, don't march that back. Now, kick out from the hip, push, kick. So now imagine you're trying to kick out that ottoman. It's right there. It's not high, it's parallel. Push, squeeze that high knee, keep those hips stacked and steady. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, four, and three, last one. All right, boom, bring it in, let's reset. Oh, flex that left foot, stack the hips, reset already.
Good. Three, two, third set. Eight, seven, six.
six, five, four, three, two. The cat and stroke on the belly. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three. Up and barely drop. Lift, barely drop. Don't want to get shoulder width and not lifted. They're not coming off that core because you're squeezing around the spine. They're staying squeezed back and down. Your spine is imprinted into the mat. Again. Exhale, inhale. It's small, it's controlled. Elbows wide, have you for your vision. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Keep lifting, keep lifting. Extend right leg all the way to the floor. Touch the foot, don't lose any traction. Keep those hips stacked. Now, we're going to put that leg barely on the floor down. Lift. Lift. Keep it flexed. Exhale, inhale. Hands to behind that head. Eight. Seven, six, it's not that big. It's not that big. Four more. Four. And three. Two more. One more. Keep lifting, but bring that back leg in. Lift. Now, extend the other leg. Keep it on the floor. Flex the foot. Reset the spine and the hips. Now a little lift. Lift. If you look at mine, it barely lifts off that floor. Hips are stacked and steady. Spine imprinted on the floor. Shoulder blades still contracted. Again, look up, exhale, inhale. Four more, four, three, two. Keep lifting, both knees are bent. Lift, it's still not big. Again, lift. We've got four more, we're gonna hold. Four, three, you've got two. Lift and hold, stay there. Take your left arm. I want you to spider the fingers, put them on the floor, hollow the palm, shoulder blade contracted, right elbow crossover for two. So just the right shoulder blade comes off that floor. That elbow stops dead center towards the ceiling. Exhale. Good. Inhale. Do it again. Exhale. Feel the external obliques and transverse abdominis. Again. Hand supports the head. No stress. Singles. Let's go. Eight. Seven, six, five, four more, four, keep those fingers spider, two more, one more time, lift up and pull two sets, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, second set, right here, take eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one, bring it down. Left hand comes behind, right hand spiders, contract the shoulder blades, left arm crosses over. So my right arm is not resting on the floor, my fingertips are spidered, and just the tips of the fingers are pressing into the floor. Shoulder blades are pulled back and down, spine still imprinted, hips stacked and steady. And behind the head for support, there's no stress in the neck. External obliques, transverse abdominis. Four more here. Four. And three. Blow that hair out. Two more. One more. We've got singles before we pause. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four more. Four. And three. Two more to go. One more time. Double set of pulses. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three, second set, go. Eight, seven, good. Six, five, four, three, center, lift it up. Contract the shoulder blades. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, last four, four, and three. Two more, right knee, left knee comes in, opposite elbow crosses, left to right, right to left to right, right to left. Final eight, eight, seven, good, good, good. Six, five, last four, four, three, last two, last one, hug it in. Nicely done. Roll those knees around in a nice big circle. We deserve our stretch. Can you Keep those hands on the knees and step from the circle them away from each other at the same time. Make sure the hands are circling those knees. And then let's pause in the middle and reverse them inside and away from each other. Make sure the hands are circling the knees. Two more. And hug them in nice and deep. Find the shins. Pull those knees in. Feel the grounding of the spine. Just drop the right leg down. Hug the left leg in. Hold it in nice and tight. Let's extend the leg to the ceiling. Find the bend in the leg. Tap on the ankle. Pull that leg towards your chest. Open up that right arm. Let the left arm. Follow the left leg towards the floor, opening out to the side so you feel the inner thigh release. And bring it back up, cross that ankle over the bottom thigh. Palms don't push that knee away, maybe a little, maybe a lot. When you're ready, place the hands between, find the hands. Remember, we're going to uncross, you're going to hug the leg you're holding, and let's chin back in, opposite leg goes right to the floor. And then extend it to the ceiling, grab the bend in the leg, an ankle in the calf, pull that quad right towards your chest, and stretch the glute and hand. The right leg opens up to the side, the right arm follows, holds and supports. And we're going to help that leg right back up, take that ankle across that bottom thigh, maybe the palm pushes that knee away a little or a lot. Just help to open up that hip. And then when you're ready, lace the hands right between, find that hamstring, pull it back up and in. Uncross, bring those hands, drop your bodies up, turn it over to your hands and your knees. Arch your back into your cow. Feel the stretch in your core. Push your palms right to the floor, stand in the air. Contract, round through, tuck your chin, round back, to bring those shoulder blades. Turn those toes down, lift the hips into your downward facing dog, pull the heels down, pull the shoulders down towards your hips. Feel a stretch in the calves, the back of the legs. Good, walk your hands back to your toes. Bend the knees, hands on your thighs, flat back. And roll this up, shoulders up and around and back. Open them up right behind, stretch them through the chest. Don't forget all that chest work, all that chest press, chest flies. Good. Bring the arms up, grab that right elbow, pull it down through your tricep. Guys, awesome work. Phantom out, switch. Guys, awesome work. Thank you so much.